as crews were busy packing up tents, fencing, and other remnants of Elvis Fest at Bear Park. Staffers were reviewing a long checklist in their first post-Elvis Fest strategy session.
We need to think really, really hard about probably assigning a blue team member or finding a blue team member to serve at the information booth.
And storing merchandise and other items in the warehouse.
So we house all of our banners, our duct tape, our zip ties, all of that is housed here, and we need to get it in order so we'll know what we need to replace for next year.
Daphne Hendricks helps market the festival. She says visitors from out of town had high marks for Tupelo, its people, and the surrounding area.
They love coming to the festival itself because they get to see their favorite guys compete for the tribute artist competition. But more than that, they love the people of Tupelo and they love the hospitality they receive from the minute they step foot in town until that last day when they leave, and there are lots of hugs and kisses being passed, and on top of that, they make new friends.
By all accounts, events at the Lyric Theater were the most popular attractions during the festival. The Ultimate Elvis Tribute Artist Competition and special concerts there all sold out.
The competition is just very challenging across the board. You know, everyone wants to win, and we see a little bit of that. I think one of the best challenges we've overcome this year was the connections that we made, not only with the Elvis Festival, but some community involvements we've never had before, with our winner last year participating in a church service here in Tupelo at First Methodist.
And many veteran volunteers, such as Jan Pannell, reported signs of an annual condition common to many festival workers.
Post-Elvis Festival blues, kind of the day after festival, it's a little bit of a letdown. We always say it's like the day after Christmas. You've shopped and shopped and shopped and managed to get everybody's present under the tree, but the day after Christmas, it's all over very, very quickly. There's lots of planning that goes into this festival through the year, and it seems like it comes and goes very, very quickly.
Jan and other volunteers won't have to wait long to get back to work. In a couple of weeks, a core group of volunteers will have a meeting, and then staffers will go on a retreat next month, and they'll start hammering out ideas and themes for next year's Elvis Fest. In Tupelo, I'm Allie Martin, WCBI News.